DuPont is always in the news, it seems like, for killing people. Either they're involved in massive environmental cases where they kill people, or they're just involved with killing people right at their plant. Yeah, I have a question, and I know you've followed this. I certainly have followed this because I have cases against DuPont, legal, you know, court cases against DuPont, and I know the inner workings of them. But it's amazing that corporate media doesn't pick up the story about how dysfunctional this corporation is and the way that it treats people. Talk about a little bit the developing cases that we see against DuPont.
It's obvious from just looking through their history that this is a corporation that has absolutely no regard for human life whatsoever. And I mean, that's a bold statement to make, but their history completely backs that up. One of the most recent things that we've seen show up in the news is the fact that the OSHA finally decided to issue a fine to DuPont for killing four workers at a pesticide plant in Texas. Unfortunately, OSHA decided that those four lives were only worth about $99,000, and so that's what they fined DuPont. Now, this is a company that has a market value of over $64 billion. And for killing four people, OSHA decided just to fine them $99,000. And yeah, that's pretty insulting to the family of those people to understand that, you know,
$25,000 a life is what OSHA believes it's worth. Well, it used to be that OSHA would shut a plant down until they got things right. And now, first of all, we have to remember the venue here is Texas. We have to begin with, where are we? Okay, we're in Texas. The DuPont plant is in Texas. The culpability here is overwhelming. They had been warned about violations, and this was so outrageous that one of the employees actually opened a line and allowed this poisonous gas to escape. Three other people come to her rescue, and all four of them die. Now, the problem is, A, OSHA has a horrible history of inspecting to begin with, all right? But here, they did inspect. They found violations, which is remarkable to begin with, because OSHA has become an organization that, just like the FDA, just like the EPA, is owned by, and the SEC, I could go on forever, is owned by the industry that they're supposed to be overseeing. We have story after story of people that used to work with OSHA going to work with companies like DuPont. And so here, this is a classic example of, gee whiz, we're going to look the other way. We don't think a life is worth more than $25,000. Kill four people. And you know what, Farron, there's more to this story, isn't it? Because they had a history of this, didn't they?
Well, there is. OSHA had, as you pointed out, they had inspected that plant, came up with countless violations, presented them to DuPont and said, okay, here are the areas that you need to fix. Your workers are not trained properly. You don't have proper safety precautions in place. These are serious problems. You're likely going to end up killing people if you don't fix these problems. And then OSHA did the most disturbing thing of all, and they said, have a nice day. Did not go back to that plant until after these people had been killed by DuPont's negligence.
Yeah.
And that's symptomatic of what the OSHA has been doing for years with DuPont.
Well,
they have other plants that have over two dozen violations. They've done absolutely nothing.
Farron, people watching this program believe that agencies out there are doing their job. This is bigger than just OSHA and DuPont. We both know the history of DuPont. It's awful. I mean, if you look at the history, just years before, I think it was around 2007, two people died there. I think the fines that went with that are something like $1,700 and $1,900 for death of these people. So what's happened is people don't understand that there is nobody looking over the shoulder of people like DuPont. OSHA's not doing it. Add to that what's also developing in places like Texas is they're trying to shut down lawsuits that are the only avenue open for these families. For example, four people dead. OSHA says the death of that person's worth $25,000 or less. And so what happens to the children? Who takes care of the children? Who takes care of the spouse? Who takes care of the bills that mount up after a death like this? taxpayers do. Because right. in Texas, what ends up happening is they say they're trying to shut lawsuits down almost completely, close the door to the courtroom, and now you have agencies that have become completely dysfunctional, like OSHA that we see right here, like the FDA, like EPA, like the SEC, you name it. We're living in a time where the conservatives have accomplished exactly what they want. There is no oversight.
Right. Well, and, you know, building on that a little bit, you pointed out earlier the fact that, you know, we have this revolving door that exists between the industry and the regulatory agencies, and that's very clear. And the second part of the problem is that the Republicans are following the Grover Norquist, model of government, which is make it so small you can drown it in a bathtub. So they cut the budgets for these agencies. OSHA has enough inspectors that if they wanted to go through every corporation in the United States, they would be able to do each company once every 139 years. That is how badly we've cut it. And the few that are left there, the less than 2,000 employees, are captive of the industry itself. So it's a double-edged sword here where we have so few workers and the few that are left are always beholden to industry and not to making sure that the people who work at these companies are safe.
And of course, you have Fox News, who is all behind trying to accomplish every one of those issues. It's amazing. Two or three great articles where they tracked What is Fox News selling? What is it that they're selling to the American public? And then they analyzed, are they selling the Grover Norquist issue? Well, it was overwhelming. They looked at the number of stories, the number of attempts to go at that story. Are they selling the deregulation of organizations like OSHA? Overwhelming number of stories by Fox trying to do that. Are they selling closing the courthouse door to people who are injured and don't have any other avenue? Overwhelming number of stories by Fox.